The Massivan's Triangle, named after a Scottish surgeon, 1864 to 1924, Sir William Massivan. Now, watch carefully. The boundaries of the triangle are the posterior superior bony meatal wall, the root of the zygoma, also called the supramastoid crest, and a vertical line. Please note the important word vertical. A vertical line perpendicular to the supramastoid crest, tangent to the posterior superior bony meatal wall, subtending within a tiny triangular area. This is the Massivan's triangle. I repeat again, the boundaries are the posterior superior bony meatal wall, the supramastoid crest, and a vertical line perpendicular to the supramastoid crest, tangent to the posterior border of the posterior superior bony meatal wall. We should not draw the line in this fashion, although that again is a tangent. Why? Deeper within is the sigmoid sinus and the overlying sinus plate. And if this is the line drawn, we can traumatize the sigmoid sinus, causing torrential hemorrhage. To avoid all that, again the Massivan's triangle is root of zygoma supramastoid crest, posterior superior bony meatal wall, and a vertical line drawn tangent to the posterior border. This subtends the McEwen's triangle. 14 millimeter deep to it is the mastoid antrum. And overlying it, the surface landmark is the simba concave, which we will press or palpate in order to elicit tenderness in the Massivan's triangle, suggestive of involvement of the mastoid antrum. The location of the mastoid antrum is denoted by the Massivan's triangle.